Hello, my name is Dr. Sanket Pisat and I am a consultant gynecological minimal access surgeon practicing in Mumbai, India. In this video today, we are going to be discussing hysteroscopic removal of polyp, also called as hysteroscopic polypectomy. The normal female reproductive system consists of the uterus, which lies in the center, and a pair of fallopian tubes and ovaries, one on each side of the uterus. This uterus is the organ that normally harbors the child and where the pregnancy grows. The uterus has an inner lining, which is also referred to in medical terminology as the endometrium. On the two sides of the uterus are the two openings of the fallopian tubes, also called as the tubal ostia. So there is a tubal ostium on the right side and a tubal ostium on the left side. Normally, during the process of intercourse, the sperm enters through the vagina and the egg or the ovum is released by the ovary. The ovum then travels through the fallopian tube and the sperm travels through the uterus until finally both of them meet inside the fallopian tube at a point somewhere close to the tubal ostium. Once these two have met, the pregnancy starts forming, and in due course of time, this pregnancy finds its way back into the uterus as shown by the golden symbol called the embryo. Sometimes a localized endometrial overgrowth, which is called as a polyp, prevents this from happening and prevents the embryo from implanting or growing inside the uterus, causing infertility. This is the normal view of the inside of the uterus, which is a spacious cavity, and you can see the right tubal opening, which is seen from inside the uterus, and a mirror image of this, which is the left tubal opening, which is also seen from inside the uterus. So the endometrial lining is normally smooth and does not have any localized outgrowths. A submucosal fibroid typically projects inside the endometrial cavity, bulging the cavity from within. These type of fibroids usually give complaints like heavy menstrual bleeding, painful periods, irregular bleeding between periods, and infertility. Here we see one such globular fibroid, which is seen to be projecting into the endometrial cavity. This area has been marked out by a blue line for reference. This globular fibroid has to be first detached from its attachment to the normal uterine musculature. Hence, using an electrical loop, shaving of the fibroid is carried out, also known in medical terminology as resection of the fibroid. So, using an electrical loop, the fibroid is first being slowly separated from its attachment to the surrounding normal musculature. And once that is done, the fibroid is scooped out from its attachment site using the electrical cautery. Small pieces of the fibroid are made and detached gradually until such time that the normal uterine musculature is seen. These small bits are removed from the uterus after surgery and from time to time to make visualization of the endpoint of surgery easier. Here, we see that the fibroid has now been completely removed and the normal uterine musculature can now be seen. This site of the fibroid where it was earlier located is marked out by the two red lines. Hence, the fibroid has now been completely removed and the patient will have complete relief of symptoms from the next cycle onwards. If you like the video, please click on the icon above to subscribe to our channel. Thank you.